Good morning, Patriots. Welcome to Rex Pine CV. I'm Danielle Santiago. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now for our school mission statement.
We the Patriots achieve greatness through high expectations, passion, and perseverance.
Thank you. You may now be seated. Today is Wednesday, May 20th, 2020. Now let's go to Ms. Tucker.
Good morning, Patriot families. Ms. Tucker here with your tip of the week. Yesterday, some of our Patriot families had the opportunity to take their NWEA assessment. There's just a couple of things that I want you guys to remember when taking your test. First, make sure that you're getting a good night's rest. Second, make sure you eat a great breakfast, but not too heavy. And last, but definitely not least, make sure that you're using all of the test-taking strategies your teachers have taught you throughout this school year. I know you guys will do great. Back to you, Danielle.
Thank you, Ms. Tucker. That was awesome. Now let's go to Jaden to see what's happening today in history.
Thank you, Danielle. Today in history, on May 20th, 1914, Harry James and his orchestra recorded You Made Me Love You. The famed band leader made many movie appearances and was one of the most successful of his time. Now let's go to Nathaniel to see what to do today if you're bored and stuck indoors.
Thank you, Jaden. Hello, Patriots family. Welcome to Things to Do If You're Bored. For today's activity, we're going to be making a paper fish.
This is what it looks like. Here are the steps. Fold the edge of your paper into a triangle. Then trim the side of your paper. Then fold an edge. Cut slits starting at the edge. Make sure you don't go all the way. Then repeat all the steps to make another one. And glue the two pieces together. Then glue the tail onto the fish. Glue in both sides of the fish. Then glue the other sides. Cut a slit in the mouth and fold back to create lips. Then draw an eye and glue it onto the fish. Secure the fish with tape, and you're all done.
Wow, wasn't that great? Now I have this awesome toy that you can play with. Remember, if you do this DIY, send a picture or video to pines.renaissance@gmail.com. And don't forget to check in tomorrow for the next DIY and stay creative. Now let's go back to Danielle.
Thank you, Nathaniel. Now here are some highlights from Mr. Richardson's students.
Blurry and blind, I picked all the pieces up off the ground. Got dirt on my fingers, but that's gone now. Got the glue in my hands, I'm sticking to the plan.
Why did the bee cross the road? Because it was busy. Why did the turkey cross the road? To prove it wasn't chicken.
Wow, wasn't that great? Now let's go to weather with Vani.
Thank you, Danielle. Today's weather in Pembroke Pines, Florida is forecasted to be 87 degrees Fahrenheit and thunderstorms. Now, let's go back to Samuel for the joke of the day.
Thank you, Barney. And here's today's joke of the day. Four men are in the hospital waiting room because their wives are having babies. A nurse goes up to the first guy and says, "Congratulations, you're the father of twins." "That's odd," answers the man. "I work for the Minnesota Twins." A nurse says to the second guy, "Congratulations, you're the father of triplets." "That's weird," answers the second man. "I work for the 3M company." A nurse tells the third man, "Congratulations, you're the father of quadruplets." "That's strange," he answers. "I work for the Four Seasons Hotel." The last man is groaning and banging his head against the wall. "What's wrong?" all the others ask. "I work for 7-Up. Now let's go back to Nino.
Thanks, Sam. That was hilarious. In admin announcements, teachers, please be on your Moodle page to welcome your scholars in the morning. Attendance must be taken at some point each day. And lastly, teachers, please don't forget to provide our scholars with positive hero points. Patriots, don't forget your past expectations. Represents, present yourself positively, act kindly towards others, treat the school's environment respectfully, and succeed at everything. Congrats, Ms. Mraz, Mr. Santiago, and Ms. Milholm. You had the correct answer to yesterday's riddle, which was, what is so fragile that saying its name breaks it? The correct answer to the riddle was silence. Now for today's riddle. A little girl goes to the store and buys 1 dozen eggs. As she is going home, all but 3 break. How many eggs are left unbroken? Once again, a little girl goes to the store and buys 1 dozen eggs. As she is going home, all but 3 break. How many eggs are left unbroken? Teachers, please send your answers to pines@renaissance.gmail.com before 10 a.m. in order for your responses to be reviewed. Winners will be announced the following day. Everyone at RBTV would like to wish you a wonderful Wednesday. And remember, reset your mindset. Have a great day. Thank you.